We're at the cheapest, grittiest hotel in Guyana here in Lethem. Might be a brothel, but there's a party going on outside with the street vendors, and this is the eye of the tiger. We're in Georgetown, Guyana. A thunderstorm is moving in. We've been here a few days, and this country is horribly expensive to travel around. Unless you're a millionaire or have a private jet, the only way to do anything is with a rental car. So we will be driving on the left, 400 miles down a dirt road to the savannah, and we'll be back. We have 8 days to do it. What could go wrong? Here we go. Guyana is a rugged jungle nation in South America. We rented a car with really no specific plan, knowing that every day would be an adventure. Just getting out of Georgetown was complete madness.
Detour to the left. This guy's merging on the left. What? I just turned the windshield wipers on instead of the blinker.
After Georgetown ended, the jungle quickly began, and we put our adventure in high gear.
We've made it past the town of Linden, where the traffic ends, the potholes begin. The earth is red and the jungle beckons.
The potholes were relentless for several hours and we thought it would never end. Eventually, it did. We were then left to be on a dirt road with fewer potholes where we could travel faster and smoother and only see a car about once an hour.
After Linden, the road became just the worst pothole nightmare suffer fest in the entire world. And that went on for about 4 hours. Now the potholes have mostly ended. We just passed the police checkpoint, and we are on this fantastically narrow, deserted, quiet road with the jungle nearly reaching across it, and there's hardly any potholes. At this point, we're about halfway across Guyana, and this is a checkpoint. This is the ferry across the Essequibo River. It's not even a boat, it's just like a floating platform. This is the platform across the largest river in Guyana, the third largest in South America after the Amazon and the Orinoco.
After crossing the Essequibo River, the jungle becomes completely pristine and is filled with all sorts of interesting creatures.
This is a huge flock of butterflies. Look at how beautiful it is.
Trumpeter birds just appeared in the road.
We're passing yet another incredible bird watching spot.
We think there's all sorts of weird noises, even though we can't see anything. So we're pulling over, we have the binoculars, the zoom camera, and we are looking for the cock of the rock or anything else we can find. Here we go. We asked many locals where we could find the fabled cock of the rock and made several visits and spent hours and hours waiting in the jungle to try to find it. Eventually, we were left with just a fleeting glance of it, but it was an incredible experience of bright orange plumage fluttering across the canopy. We just saw the fabled cock of the rock, one of the most exotic and colorful birds in these jungles. And then it was gone. So we're waiting here, it's already been an hour, to see if they come back. Near the exact center of Guyana, the road kind of deteriorates in that it goes over multiple little streams with some of the worst quality wooden bridges you could ever imagine.
What do you think of this one?
After the bridges, the jungle kind of ends as it transitions into savanna.
So we just rolled up to the village of Sarama, where there's this really informal eco lodge that's been closed for several years. But the girl said, yeah, you can camp anyway.
We spent a whole day in the jungle around Sarama looking for wildlife. We saw an anaconda, we saw huge locusts, we saw more birds than I can even recall. And we heard a lot of sounds in the jungle that we are not able to identify, and we cautiously poked around at.
There's a trail here, we have maps. We're gonna go climb Sarama Mountain.
When trekking in Guyana, the only thing on your mind is snakes.
definitely not the trail. It's just a muddy resurgence of water from where I don't know. There's no trail here. Sarama Mountain, we're not gonna find it. Let's exit this hike.
We're crossing the savanna, not far from Brazil. Temperature is 41 Celsius. That's like 105 or 106 Fahrenheit. Just unbelievably hot, windy. There's just termite mounds stretching across the horizon. There's no anteaters to be seen at this hour. It's just too hot.
As we drove closer and closer to Lethem, the terrain became mostly flat and more arid and hotter, and the entire ecosystem changed. We knew we were getting close to something incredible. We finally entered a green paradise.
This will be our campsite. It's a nice parking area. It's supposed to pour rain tonight, and we are not gonna set up the tent. We're gonna sleep in the car. Once you get used to it, it's not so bad. It appears that we have found the macaw tree. There's like at least a dozen macaws in this tree, right alongside a laughing falcon. They're so beautiful, but they're so obnoxious. They're like the loudest bird. And they're so bad at hiding. That's why we found them. We bumped along the savanna road for about an hour, only covered like 20 kilometers. And we have found Kumu Falls. Not exactly swimmable, not jumpable, not really the nicest jungle waterfall, to be honest. The storm is here! The storm is here! We're taking shelter! This is crazy! We slept in the car last night. It thunderstormed and rained all night. It's probably rained about 2 inches. It's still just pouring. The road's flooded. We're trying to get back to Lethem. Here we go.
Gonna make it!